try these workouts because you're going to make the gains with me. I don't want to be selfish and get all the gains for your team. I want you to make them with me. That way we all can be gain certified. Strength Team family, look, I'm right back with another great video. If you're new to the Strength Team family, welcome to the Strength Team family. All we do over here is get gains. If you have any video suggestions or any video requests, all you got to do is put it at the bottom and I promise you I'll make that video happen. And as always, make sure you smash that like button, Strength Team. Like I've been telling you this week, let's make sure that every single video gets at least 1,000 likes. And all y'all out there that's already been smashing the like button, whether I tell you or I don't tell you, a major salute. You are the reason it's helping the family grow. That's way too much talking, so let's jump straight into this workout. What we got today is it is a shoulder and chest workout, but you do not have to do the chest part. I'm just trying to beefing up my upper portion of my chest, and as you see, the chest is growing. So our first exercise, we have 6 sets with the dumbbell side raises. I know you're probably rolling your eyes and looking at me like I am a madman, because that's exactly what my workout partners did, felt like, said, and everything. But after like the 4th set into it, they started getting that pump feeling and they loved it. So like you're seeing the video, I want you to start out like a warm-up. So I got 25 reps. Then my next set, of course, I'm going to add weight. Now I have 20 reps. After I finish with those, now I have 15 reps. Then after I finish with that, I have the 20 pounds and I'm going to stay at 15 reps. And after I finish with that, now I got the 30 pounds. Now I got 12 reps. Now my heaviest set, I'm going to grab the 35 pounds and I'm going to go to 8 to 9 to even 10 reps. Immediately after I finish with that, you already know what I'm going to do, Strength Team. I got a double drop set. So I went from the 35s, I think I got it for like 10 reps. Then I dropped it down to like the 25s. And then I think I got it for another like 8 to 9 reps. And then I went down to like the 15s. And then I think I even got that for like maybe 10 to 12 reps. And honestly, I think I even dropped it down again to like the 10, Strength Team, and got another 10 reps because I'm serious about my gains and I'm trying to build up these cannons. Now to finish with that, we have the incline plate front raise. We have 3 sets and we're going to stay between 8 to 10 reps. Now this right here is going to humble you. A lot of people like to do them standing up. You know why? Because they can look stronger. They can move more weight. Soon as you lay down on that incline, oh man, all that ego is gone. The ego is done. You have no momentum. You have no way to cheat the weight up. So your delts got to fight for themselves. You cannot help them. So I highly suggest you to try this out. Like you're seeing, I got my chest hanging a little bit off the bench. Now I'm just going to bring the plate all the way up right in front of my face and I'm going to hold it for a half second and I'm going to come back down controlling it and I'm going to repeat that. Now you don't have to increase your weight. I think I used 35 pounds and that was plenty. And just like every other exercise, that third set is going to be a drop set. So with the 45 pound plate, I think I got like 8 or 9 reps. Immediately I dropped that down. Now I picked the 25 pound plate up and now I did it to failure. I just went, I didn't even count reps. Like I always tell in my videos, I go until I feel the burn. Once I feel the burn, then I try to do 8 to 9 or even 10 more reps. Now to finish with that, we have the incline dumbbell rear delt flies. We have 3 sets and we're going to stay between 10 to 12 reps. Like I just told you, it's going to take all the momentum, all your ego, everything needs to be left at the door at this workout because this is going to humble you. So like you're seeing in the video, I got my chest hanging a little off the bench and I'm just going to literally just pull my arm straight up while I'm thinking about squeezing my rear delts. The best way to think about this is act like you have a rope. Now just take that rope in both hands and just pull the rope apart. That's all you got to think about, and I promise you that's going to simplify this exercise and make you think less, but you're going to gain more. Now like I tell in every single exercise, that third set is a drop set. So I think I had like 15 pounds and I think I may have got like 11 or 12 reps. Immediately I dropped it down to like the 5 pounds and then I went for another like 10 to 11 to maybe even 12 reps. The pump in my delts after these 3 exercises honestly was probably enough for the workout to be done. But you know how I am, Strength Team. I'm gain certified and I want to get these gains. So we got the dumbbell shoulder press. When I told my workout partners we got the dumbbell shoulder press, they both at the same time looked at me like I was crazy. I'm honestly starting to think, Strength Team, I'm going to be real with you. I might be a little crazy. I ain't going to lie to you. I might be a little crazy. But it's crazy for those gains. You've got to be crazy for those gains if you really just want to get them. We have 4 sets and we're going to stay between 8 to 10 reps. I know you're going to be like, I'm going to be dead by this point. Just act like this is your first exercise. So I want you to increase the weight every single set. I want you to count 1, 2, Three, on the way down, now press it up and squeeze your shoulders. Now come right back down and again, count 3 seconds. Every single set, strength team, strive to add weight. If you have a workout partner, that's even better, because when you're slowing your negatives down to like 1 to 2 to 3 seconds, that's gonna make you fail out so much faster. But I promise, guys, you're gonna make so much better gains. That fourth set is a drop set. So like I think I went to like 70s, maybe 75 pounds, and I was coming down super slow, counting 1, 2, 3, just like that until I go to failure. I think I may have got like 6 or 7 reps. Then I immediately dropped that down. Now I picked up some lighter dumbbells and I went right back in, strength team, with the same principle and the same tempo, and repped it until failure. And I wanted a little bit more gains because I wasn't happy, because I think I only got like 5 reps. So I picked the weight back up and went right back in there and got another 3 to 4 reps. Now, honestly, strength team, you're done. Like, your shoulders should be like ridiculously pumped up by now. But if you want to bring up your chest like I have been doing, I promise you definitely try to start training your chest at least 2 times a week. Now, I don't mean going there and do like 8 exercises. Literally 2 exercises all we're going to do, and it's just going to cap off our chest nicely. Now, I went to a new gym, and honestly, I've been considering making this my new home gym. It's 25 minutes away, but the equipment, the vibe, I just like it. I just feel like I'm ready for a change. Like, I like everything about this gym, so you may see in the near future that this is going to be my new home gym. But they have a lot of hammer strength machines, and I just love them. So that's exactly what we did. We did the incline hammer press, 3 sets, 8 to 10 reps, and we superset it with the standing underhand grip flies. When I tell you that the pump in my chest hurt, it literally hurt. I normally train my chest and shoulders on the same days, but I have never trained my shoulders first and then my chest after. After doing it like this, I promise you, it's going to stay like this, because I instantly had a pump in my chest. Like, the first exercise, I already had a pump. Now, like you're seeing in the video, I still want you to control your reps when you're doing the hammer press. Like you're seeing, I'm still coming down somewhat slow. Maybe not 3 seconds slow, but at least 1 to 2 seconds. Now, press it up and squeeze your chest. You're going to do this for every single rep, and that third set is going to be a drop set, and I want you to go to failure on your drop set. Every time we do a drop set, guys, we go to failure. People's like, what is failure? Failure is when you cannot do another one. And then if you feel like you didn't get enough out of your failure, rest for like 5 seconds and go right back in and go to failure again. That's how you're going to break down the muscles so we can rebuild them bigger and stronger. So after you finish your reps with your hammer press, immediately go over there to the cable flies. Now I want you to do a standing cable fly. I'm using an underhand grip. If you've never tried to do a fly like that, try it, strength team, and I guarantee it, you will start incorporating it in every single chest workout that you do. It's just going to make your whole entire chest come alive throughout the range of the motion. Like, at the beginning, I could feel that stretch in the upper, and the further I go out, I could feel it in the lower. I'm telling you, it is perfect. And on these, we're going to failure for every single set, and then that third set, you already know how I get down. The third set is a drop set to failure. Now, I normally don't do extremely high volume workouts. This is like 21 total sets, so in all honesty, it's not really super high volume, but this workout took like 1 hour and 15 minutes. It was 3 of us, but I promise you, it was like on a Friday. The vibe was great, the workout was great, the pump was great. It was just an overall great workout, so I highly suggest you to try this one out. You do not need to change anything. If you do not have the hammer press machine, all you got to do is either the incline Smith machine, or you can do the incline dumbbell. It's going to be the exact same thing. But like I tell you in every single video, strength team, make sure you like this video and this video. Make sure you share this video. But at the end of the day, what I always tell you, make sure you keep getting them gains. You have to eat the dream. You have to sleep the dream.